Beloved, we want to tidy up this week. God has been good to us. God has blessed us. We are learning mysteries about spiritual warfare from the Lord. I want you to consider once again Judges chapter 1. I want to read, and after the death of Joshua, it came to pass that the children of Israel asked the Lord, saying, "Who shall go up for us against the Canaanites first to fight against them?" And the Lord said, "Judah shall go up. Behold, I have delivered the land into his hand. The time has come for this generation to put into practice what the fathers have taught us. The time has come, beloved, for us to inquire of the Lord and hear from him before we make our moves." Hallelujah. "And Judah said unto Simeon his brother, Come up with me into my lot, that we may fight against the Canaanites. And I likewise will go with thee into thy lot." So Simeon went with him. Glory to God. May God position people in your life that will be willing to partner with you. May that become my portion, O Lord. People that will be willing to partner with Resurrection Harvest for All Nations in end time global harvest. We are beginning whole crusades around this city. And before long, we will have major crusades in various parts. And just believe in God that churches will join us. And Simeon agreed to go with Judah. There are some exciting mysteries concerning that. So Simeon went with him, and Judah went up, and listen to this, "And the Lord delivered the Canaanites and the Perizzites into their hand." The peddlers of defeat to humble and subdue, with the small-minded Perizzite trying to limit your scope and keep you tiny and frustrated all these years. May the Lord deliver both of them into your hands in Jesus' name. There was a couple. He's a Nigerian guy married to an American woman. They used to go to this church, and all of a sudden I didn't see them anymore. And then I found the man at K&G, one of those stores, doing security. And I was so surprised. I said, what happened to you guys? He said, "Well, nothing, nothing." I said, "Come on, tell me the truth." He said, "Well, it's my wife." "What is it about your wife?" He said that my wife loves small churches. And she said that the church is already too big for her. I said, "Please, you parasite, stay gone from me in Jesus' name." But beloved, in all honesty, I don't even believe that that was the case. I think because I went home and I brought pictures of a house in the village, and as soon as I showed that, jealousy and pride rose up and they left, probably because they didn't have any house like that in their place. But then even at that, the Perizzite has no place in your life. Anybody limiting God in your life, you need to get out of that relationship. May God deliver you from every Perizzite. May God deliver you from every Canaanite in Jesus' name. All relationships that limit your focus and limit your scope and limit your excellence and your belief and expectation in God, I cancel them today in the name of Jesus. I thwart their strategy and their weaponry in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord delivered the Perizzites and the Canaanites into the hand of Judah, and they slew of them in Bezek 10,000 men. Woo, what a carnage. Can you imagine 10,000 men laying on the floor? What it would look like? Wow. That would be very traumatic for anybody to see. And they found Adoni-Bezek in Bezek, and they fought against him, and they slew the Canaanites and the Perizzites. But Adoni-Bezek fled, and they pursued after him and caught him and cut off his thumbs and his great toes. This guy is very fun. Now watch this. "And Adoni-Bezek said, 70 kings, having their thumbs and their great toes cut off, gathered their meat under my table. As I have done, so God hath requited me." You see? These are spiritual laws. And many times you are worried about people and what they have done and not knowing that God's judgment stands. So as I have done, this man had more understanding than many believers. As I have done, so has it been done to me. I have 70 kings with their toes cut off, with their thumbs cut off. And their great toe cut off, their thumb and their great toe. He said, they ate at my table. God has done to me as I have done to them. Now the children of Judah, and they brought him to Jerusalem, and there he died. That's what I was saying. He died. 70 kings with their great toe and their thumbs cut off ate at his table, but when the thing was done to him, he died. Are you one of these people dishing out what you cannot handle? Then the warfare will be against you from the Lord your God instead of against the enemy. He died. Now the children of Judah had fought against Jerusalem and had taken it and had smitten it with the edge of the sword and set the city on fire. Ooh, beloved, isn't that something? That man could not handle what he was dishing out. May God annihilate every Canaanite and Perizzite. I'll be talking to you about this mystery next week of Simeon going with Judah into the battle. You see the blessing out of it. And I encourage you to get them to partner with people with covenants with God, and you will see great victory and great blessing manifesting your life. In Jesus' name. We love you. May God bless you and give you increase. May He strengthen you and clear up your clouded vision and reveal to you what He has planned for you. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.